In this episode, we were surprised by Krabi, Thailand,
where the whole family hiked to the summit of Tiger Cave Temple.
And we got to experience Krabi's amazing night market. Join us on this wild adventure. We are the Traversing Family.
Krabi is a great hub for exploring Southwest Thailand.
It was a 1 hour taxi and ferry ride from Koh Lanta. And we just had to, because it's an island, we had to cross that little bit with the ferry, but pretty easy to do.
So we got up early this morning and we're going to go hike up to the top of this mountain at the Tiger Cave Temple. They say it's like 1900 steps or something. Should be quite a workout. Hopefully it doesn't get too hot since we got up early. But
hey, we're hoping that all the kids can make it all the way up all those stairs, especially the youngest.
Get ready, Allie. Let's do it.
All right, here we go up to Tiger Cave Temple. And these are the temple dogs. Tiger Cave Temple. Now, despite its name, it's actually a complex of multiple temples, and the best temple is on the top of about 1,000 foot high mountain. There are also a couple other temples and caves at the base, hence the name Tiger Cave Temple. But climbing that mountain is really what it's all about, and the views are really awesome from the top. How many stairs were there?
1,260, some of which were over 30 centimeters tall, and our four-year-old was able to climb them all the way up. It's about an hour and 15 minutes or so, and there was two restrooms along the way. So just for your knowledge, with little kids, we're able to do it fairly quickly, but a little bit longer than what.
And little Ellie, who's only four, she made it up. We had to help her up a little bit, but she did it all on her own. Good job, Ellie.
Hiking up Tiger Cave Temple in Krabi. It was awesome to see all the big gold Buddha on the top. It's a hard hike up, but even my sister made it up. So I think you guys can also make it up.
From the top are absolutely beautiful. I mean, come on, where else can you see such amazing views all the way around?
So in our last video, I talked about how much we loved Koh Lanta because you didn't need to wear shoes at all. Now, you may think we just don't like to wear shoes because we're not wearing them in this video on the top of that mountain at the temple either. However, actually, all the temples in Southeast Asia do not allow you to wear shoes inside. And that's just one of many attire restrictions that you have to be aware of when you go to visit the temples.
One thing that I would note for ladies is make sure your shoulders and your knees and your mid area are all covered.
Yep, and for the guys, of course, you gotta cover your shoulders as well. No tank tops, and you can wear shorts most of the time, but they need to be longer than your knees. Really, it depends on the person at the door on the day you go, because some of them are more lenient than others. But just make sure you plan ahead, because you don't want to have to hike all the way back down if you didn't bring the right attire.
For children, there's not a set rule, but we went ahead and had our kids cover their shoulders, mid areas, and knees out of respect for those that were worshiping.
Yep, and back to the shoes again. If you don't want to walk barefoot where everybody else is walking barefoot through the temple, I suggest you wear something with socks or bring some socks along.
All right, so climbing up to the top of the Tiger Cave Temple, totally worth it, but make sure you start early because it's already almost 90 degrees at 10 in the morning and it gets hot. Thankfully, the stairs are mostly in the shade. That helps a little bit. There's a lot of forest along the way. It's not very exposed and it is awesome at the top.
Yeah, it is totally awesome.
All right, time to head back down. Let's see how fast we can get to the bottom. Look how big these steps are for Ellie. They're like higher than her knee. Imagine knee high steps. That's what Ellie's doing the whole time. Good job, Ellie.
Oh!
Yay!
No.
One of our favorite ways to get dinner was to go to the night market there in Krabi.
So every weekend, Friday through Sunday night, once the sun starts going down, the night market heats up. During the day, the town is pretty quiet because it's really hot out, but everybody comes out for the night market, and not just food, but there's all kinds of shopping opportunities as well. And the selection on hand was quite impressive. There's so many different types of food, things that I had never even heard of, and we just loved experiencing all the different foods.
My favorite in Krabi, Thailand was the market. There were tons and tons of stands that you could just grab your food on. There were tons and tons of new foods that I never tried.
What are you guys getting made here?
A Thai pancake.
Whoa, yeah.
No, Italian.
Are you sure it's not a crepe?
What?
It's just not a crepe?
Oh, it's like a crepe, just a little different.
Okay.
And?
It tastes like an egg.
It
tastes like
an egg. So there's a large airport there in Krabi. One way that you can also reach the islands of the southwest is also through Phuket. Now we chose to go through Krabi, but I wouldn't necessarily stay in Krabi itself.
Yeah, so Krabi is well connected. It has a waterfront with lots of boats waiting to take you to any of the islands or beaches nearby. But there isn't a beach actually in Krabi itself. And really, let's be honest, this area of Thailand, it's the beaches and the beautiful water, the Andaman Sea, that's the draw. So I would stay out of one of the islands, but stop through and visit Krabi. It's definitely worth it.
Join us next time
as we fly up to Chiang Mai, Thailand in the north. We're gonna go hiking with elephants and of course check out a lot of Thai temples. See you later. Bye.
Out to Chiang Mai.
Yeah.